Call the city council meeting to order. Roll call, please.
Alderman Caddella. Alderman Knipes. Alderman Coles.
Here.
Alderman Lewitton.
Here.
Alderman Police.
Here.
Alderman Shockey.
Here.
Alderman Wesley.
Here.
Alderman Winger.
Here.
Mayor Johnson.
Here. Quorum being present, would you stand and join me in the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
May I have a motion to approve the minutes of the special council meeting of October 25th, 2007? Is there a second?
Second.
Seconded by Alderman Coles. Any comments, corrections, additions? If not, all in favor say aye.
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 Opposed, motion carries. Bills, Alderman Wesley?
Make the motion, pay the bills, $192,907.75.
Is there a second?
Second.
On the question?
I have one question.
Alderman Wesley?
On page three, Dave and Jim Auto Body Work 101, could you tell me what that is for and what vehicle? Because that's the second auto body repair job I have seen on the bills in the past 2 months.
Mr. Holm?
By work on 101.
You'd be 401. 101 has to be, it's 101, maybe the blue car, the Taurus. Okay, that's what it was then. Blue 101 is the blue Taurus, the pool car from City Hall. And I guess apparently there were some dents on the fender that they took in to have fixed. I think the what's the total, 300, and that would be probably consistent with this total, $342. Yeah.
So there was an accident with the vehicle, or we just...
Not that I know of. No, this would be the pool vehicle, so...
Mr. Williams? Just...
Yes, unfortunately, that sits out sometimes in the lot, and it sits out overnight, and a lot of people come in from the police department, and it could have been somebody leaving from the police department.
I have one other question.
Alderman Wesley?
On page seven, the appraisal group, was that regarding the property that we had asked to appraise? And have we...
Mr. Williams?
Yes, that's correct, Alderman Wesley. That's the properties we were directed to have appraised.
Okay.
Anything further?
No.
Roll call.
Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
Yes.
Alderman Knipes?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Lewitton?
Yes.
That passes. Do any citizens wish to address city council this evening? If so, if you go to the podium and give us your name and address. Mr. Clavins?
Thank you very much. My name is Robert Clavins. I live in the 4300 block on Montrose in Old Irving Park, Chicago. I'm a representative, a field organizer with Environment Illinois. Environment Illinois is a statewide, nonprofit, nonpartisan environmental advocacy group. We've got about 20,000 members statewide and several hundred in this area as well. We work on a number of issues from clean water, clean air, and also open spaces. Right now, however, our main priority is working on a global warming solutions campaign. It's obviously in the news quite a bit. Everybody's heard about it, especially with recent news. Unfortunately, as Alderman Coles and I talked, Al Gore wasn't able to make it tonight, but maybe next week. Regardless, though, all joking aside, though, the debate basically about global warming is over. There's a scientific consensus, a clear scientific consensus that global warming is occurring. The 10 warmest years on record have happened since 1990. 2005 was the warmest year on record worldwide. 2006 was the warmest year on record here in the United States. In the Midwest, we can expect, if global warming continues, we can expect more hot, dry summers. Our climate, according to the Union of Concerned Scientists, will be much more like that of Oklahoma or Texas. We'll have more heat waves, more droughts. I recall the heat wave of 1995. I grew up in Milwaukee watching the heat wave of 95, where over 600 Chicagoans died. Events like that are going to become more common. And the effects of global warming are pretty frightening. We're nearing a tipping point. There's also a clear scientific consensus. The IPCC, the UN brought together the largest group of the world's most renowned climate scientists, who said with 90% certainty that most of the global warming is being caused by human causes, the main one being the burning of fossil fuels. The good news is that even though we're close to a tipping point, of which the consequences are pretty frightening, I'm sure you've heard them all, 40% of the world's species facing extinction, rising sea levels displacing hundreds of millions of people, agriculture changing, all of these bad things. The good news is that we have a chance to step away from that cliff. The technology is there, and all we really need is the political will. So far, Illinois has done some good things. We've taken the leadership on this last year, reducing energy use through energy efficiency, reduction of 2% by the year 2015. We've also required, we have some really great opportunities here in Illinois with clean biofuels, as well as solar and wind power literally in our backyards, as good solutions. So we've also required a 25% of our energy will come from renewable resources by the year 2025. The other good news is that most of this, even the most aggressive solutions are not just economically viable, but are actually good economically for the state. The United States EPA hired ICF Consultants, an international consulting firm, to look at the state of Illinois, and they said actually even the most aggressive solutions for global warming that are being proposed would increase the GDP of the state, increase employment, and also increase discretionary spending or discretionary money, extra money that people have in their pockets in the state of Illinois. There's no leadership on the federal level right now, so really there's a groundswell of support, and communities and states are taking the leadership. That momentum is growing nationwide. There are two pieces of legislation that will be on the table next year. They are on the table, but will not be voted on until next year. The first is adopting mandatory emission standards for vehicles. 12 states have already done this. They represent 1/3 of the U.S. auto market already. The federal government eventually will do this. We want to make sure that Illinois is in the new economy. When the rest of the country does this, we want to be ahead of the curve, not playing catch up. Because that will happen. And we are joining 12 other states, hoping that we'll now take the leadership in the Midwest and nationwide. The last one is capping global warming pollution from stationary sources. Again, 10 states have already done this. Capping global warming emissions by the year 2012, and by the year 2020, reducing global warming emissions to 1990 levels. Again, all technologically feasible, as well as good for the economy of the state. We expect our state legislators are going to do the right thing, particularly in this area. We also expect that they will be voting the right way. But you can be sure they are going to hear from powerful special interests on the other side that want the status quo. We want to make sure, the reason I'm here is to address you folks as community leaders. The community at large, as well as community leaders like yourself, need to make sure that our voices are heard as well, letting our state representatives know that we care and we want them to take action. So I'm asking community leaders such as yourself, the members of the board, as a board and as individuals, to speak out. I sent all of you, hopefully you all got it by email, a copy of a coalition letter. We're reaching out, building a broad coalition statewide. We've got religious leaders, teachers, local leaders signing on, and hoping you'll do the same. So asking that you'll sign that on. I have copies if you have not received it yet, and would be more than happy to give them to you. So I guess I would ask at this time, Alderman Coles, to put this on the agenda for next week.
We have it on the agenda.
Oh, great.
We're going to put it on the agenda. On the 8th.
Mr. Williams.
Yes, we can't put this on next week at committee unless we have the information and everything, and we don't have that available. We also have a committee that is working with the county and the state and the federal government to look at these different initiatives, and we'd like to have them review it and then make a recommendation for whatever you're looking for.
To whom and what would you need submitted and to whom?
You would basically submit the information. It would be reviewed first by the committee, and then it would go to the Public Health and Safety Committee and for some determination, and would go before the council for action.
And I'm not sure the individual to whom I would give this.
Actually, you can give that to Mr. Mermis outside in the hallway or in the cafeteria. We can take care of that.
Okay, tonight. We'll do.
Okay.
So is this on the agenda for next week at this time?
No, I think first we're going to send it to the Clean Air Counts Committee under Alderman Winger, and she'll make a recommendation to send it to committee after that.
All right. So.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Does anyone else wish to address the City Council this evening? Mr. Wheeler? Sir, we do rebroadcast for all the citizens, so you do need to go to the podium so the videotape can pick that up.
Thank you. Thank you, Mayor Johnson. I do have a handout. Is it okay if I distribute the handout?
If you would identify yourself for the city clerk.
Oh, I'm sorry. My name is Jim Wheeler, and I'm a resident of Wooddale, 25 years. I'm here, I'm sorry, 389 Crestwood Road.
And if you want to give the handout to Alderman Wesley, then we can sure. He can pass it down.
I'm here to I'm with the Holy Ghost School Board, and I'm involved in the casino night. And as you know, our casino night is coming up November 17th, Saturday. And I would like to thank the city, and I would like to thank the aldermen for the support that they've given Holy Ghost and the casino night. All the proceeds of the casino night are given to the students. The casino night this year is on November 17th. It starts at 6:30 p.m. and admission to the casino is free for the first hour. We have many different casino type games taking place, and I'd also like to thank Mimi Anderson. Did a wonderful job for us this year getting the word out and getting the information in the public newsletter, and I'd like to thank her as well. And every year we have tickets made up for the police department and the fire department, and this year we've also made up some tickets for the city council. And if it's okay with the alderman and the mayor, I'd like to provide those complimentary tickets to the mayor for dispersal.
I thank you for the offer, but since I'm also serving as the liquor commissioner and we waive the fee or charge a nominal fee on this, we cannot accept free tickets to the casino night.
Oh.
I have gone in the past. It's a worthwhile event, and I encourage people to go. And I think we have put it on our cable TV site advertising it, and I believe it's also on our website as well. But thank you, but we cannot accept the tickets.
Okay. What about for the fire department or police department?
Police department cannot either.
Oh, okay.
I think the fire department, however, is free to attend and get the comp tickets. But thank you.
Okay.
And I didn't mean to cut you short. Was there anything else you had to say
about
the event?
No, basically I wanted to thank the members of the city council, to invite the members of the city council. So I can't give tickets to the city council members either, huh? Well, bummer. Thank you. I appreciate your support. And the casino night is 6:30 p.m., November 17th. Thank you.
All members of the city council are free to contribute their $10 to enter the casino night on November 17th at 6:30. Anyone else wish to address the city council this evening? Hearing none, I do not have any written communiques. Under Mayor's report, I wish I had more information. We're trying to confirm the details, but it does appear there will be a Veterans Breakfast, and I don't know if Jeff has any additional information or not. Veterans Breakfast on Sunday at 8:30. Traditionally, the aldermen request to help serve the coffee. I'm a little unclear whether we'll have a memorial service at the memorial on Sunday or if that's going to be on Monday. I don't know if we have any additional information or not. If anybody, Alderman, please.
What time? That's this Sunday, the 4th. At what time?
That would be November 11th at 8:30 to 10:30 at Salt Creek Country Club. And I should state, as long as we're giving commercials here, that's for all veterans and their families to attend a free breakfast honoring the veteran for their service. And it's sponsored by Itasca Bank and Trust, the Wooddale Park District, and the City of Wooddale. So again, that's the Sunday, November 11th at 8:30 at Salt Creek Country Club. Madam Clerk, the microphone, please.
There we go. I talked to Mr. Batiste, and I think there is going to be, from what he said, there was going to be something at 11 o'clock over at the Veterans Memorial.
On Sunday?
On Sunday.
Very good. Thank you. Also under Mayor's Report, I want to advise everybody, DuPage Mayors and Managers is sponsoring a budget workshop on Tuesday, November 13th at Addison Village Hall from 8:30 to 3. And should anybody interested in attending, the costs will be underwritten by the city. You should have had that in your packet, I believe. If not, I have extra copies. It will be in your packet tomorrow. And that concludes my report, Mr. Manager.
I have no report, Mr. Mayor.
Brings us to the consent agenda. Is there any objections to any items on the consent agenda? Hearing nothing, may I have a motion to approve the agenda?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed, motion carries. Now may I have a motion to approve the items on the agenda, being the purchase of a large format printer, plotter, scanner, contract award 2007 Parkway Tree Program, contract award 2007 Sidewalk Improvements. Is there such a motion?
So moved.
Is there
second.
A
second?
Second. Roll call.
Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
Yes.
Alderman Knipe?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Wesley?
Yes.
Alderman Lewitton?
Yes.
Those items are approved. That brings us to committee chairman reports, planning, zoning, and building. Alderman Shockey?
No report.
Public Health, Safety, and Judiciary, Alderman Coles.
I'd like to make a, I had this all planned. I'd like to make a motion for an ordinance amending Chapter 5 of the Municipal Code of the City of Wooddale to provide a Class CA catering liquor license. I think there's going to be an explanation from Mr. Bond.
Well, let me see if I can get a second first.
I'll second the motion to approve.
On the question, Mr. Bond.
Yeah, what you've got before you is an ordinance essentially creating a new chapter or a new classification of liquor license. This is restricted to those individuals who currently hold a Class RV or M license. Restaurants that and apparently there's some restaurants in town that have expressed an interest in expanding their business into the catering area. Your code currently does not provide for that. So what this ordinance would allow is a creation of a catering license, which would allow the service of alcohol in connection with and in conjunction with their catering business. It does require the sale of food and beverage. In other words, it cannot be simply a phone-in alcohol delivery service under your code. It does require them to already have a liquor license for sale at their establishment, and it requires consumption of the food be served at the location where the catering is being delivered. This, if you look at the first recital or the whereas clause, this is for those service of beverages within the municipal boundaries of the city. The city does not have the legal authority to enforce beyond its or extraterritorial enforcement powers beyond its borders. So what it does is it regulates the point of sale location. So the point of sale, someone calls in a catering, they want to cater an event in Elk Grove, for example. The point of sale is technically Wooddale. They would regulate the sale through, in the city ordinance here would regulate the sale of that alcoholic beverages in Wooddale. When it goes and is delivered to another, if it's outside of the city of Wooddale, it would be up to that jurisdiction to enforce any of their ordinances and codes as it pertains to that. So this is a point of sale, not necessarily a point of distribution. Most of your ordinances are both point of sale and distribution. If you go into a restaurant, for example, you're buying it and you're consuming it on premise. So it's a point of sale. If you're going to a liquor store, you're going to purchase it, point of sale there, and you're going to distribute it. In other words, a person would walk out with that alcoholic beverage at that time. And that's traditionally how that's done. This is a slight deviation or variation from that in that you're only regulating the point of sale and the point of distribution that occurs within the city limits. If it occurs outside the city limits, it's regulated by state statute, and it's also would be regulated by another ordinance from a municipality that is where the distribution is taking place or where the delivery occurs.
So again, this is very limited to those who already hold liquor licenses from the cities. It allows them to expand their business into the catering aspect of it. And as a practical matter, I know there'd been some concerns about, you know, this would be a liquor delivery type of a business. And as a practical matter, that has not occurred in those communities that have these types of ordinances. And under our ordinance, that would be a violation of their liquor license, and the city would have the ability through the Liquor Commission, which is the mayor, to revoke that license if that were the case. That would be a violation of their license.
Any questions, Mr. Bond? Alderman Wesley?
First, my mind here at the Senate Brunei. What is a R, V, and M? Is that hard liquor, or is that beer, wine, or R is, I don't have that in front of me.
It encompasses both. And under this ordinance, it would be not only just beer and wine, but also it's liquor of all kinds would be under this particular ordinance.
But may I follow up with that, Mr. Mayor?
Alderman Wesley?
My question here is one outfit that is very interested in it already. I believe it's only a beer and wine license. Now we actually going to give them a hard liquor license. I'm just saying, according to this ordinance that we are trying to pass here, it's R, V, and M. Are we giving that other that already have a beer and wine license, are we giving them the choice for hard liquor now? And is there an additional charge? Are they upgrading their liquor license at the time too?
Mr. Bond?
No. What you're doing, and there is a liquor license charge, is an annual initial fee of $2,500 and a renewal fee of $1,500. This would allow them, consistent with the license they have. So if they have a beer and a wine license, they would be able to sell alcoholic beverages, beer and wine alcoholic beverages, as part of their catering. If they have a full alcoholic service license, that establishment would be allowed to, through a catering business, would be allowed to sell, as part of the catering business, a full alcoholic beverage. So by virtue, if somebody has a wine and beer license only and they seek a catering license, that does not expand their license into something beyond the current parameters of their license. So they couldn't go to hard liquor, for example, if they only had a beer and wine license currently.
The request is coming from Sweet Baby Ray's, who is interested primarily in serving Christmas parties. That being said, and with the limitation that this is Wooddale only, I would suspect at this fee, nobody's going to issue a CA license. So you may want to consider, I know this has already gone to committee, but reducing it to $500 for the initial fee and $250 for your renewal. Alderman, please.
Thank you.
I got a question. You just said that if he delivers in Elk Grove, it's up to Elk Grove to enforce it. What if somebody from Elk Grove wants to deliver here in the Wooddale? Do we have an ordinance against that?
Mr. Bond?
Yes, we do. Well, they're not licensed, so they would have to be licensed in the city of Wooddale in order to do that. And one of the things that we did check with the State Liquor Commission to see how they would handle something like that, because the authority the city has is limited to the authority granted to the state. And essentially, the policy that has occurred there is if there's an enforcement and the police department would note that there is alcohol being delivered to the city of Wooddale, you would have the right to determine whether or not that person who's making that delivery has a license to deliver, a point of distribution type of license to deliver within the city of Wooddale. If it's a catering outfit that's licensed in the city of Elk Grove, or village of Elk Grove, for example, that does not have a liquor license in the city of Wooddale, that would be a violation and the police can take the appropriate action. And that's why I think it's rare. These aren't that common, because it would require essentially a catering company to go to every community in which it is its customer base is located and seek a liquor license, not only where the alcohol is being sold at the point of sale, but also at the point of distribution.
How do we enforce that? I mean, is the police department going to start pulling over catering trucks?
I think Mr. Vest, Deputy Chief Vesta, is going to take that one on.
Right?
I was just going to say that's going to fall under, like, the other situation.
we're not going to be knocking down every catering truck that comes into town. But if we learn that there's a catering truck in town that's serving alcohol without a license, then we'll take enforcement action.
Anything further?
Roll call.
Are you...
Wait, before we have a roll call, the mayor made a suggestion. Don't we have to vote on the mayor's suggestion?
You don't... No, you don't have to vote. It would be up to the move-in and the seconder whether they agree with my suggestion or not. But again, I would suspect that this $2,500 figure, given that it's limited only to Wooddale, that none of these licenses are going to get issued at that rate. Alderman Wesley?
The only drawback I have on this, you know, not that I don't trust the business. I'm not saying I don't trust the business. I think it's come case-to-case basis. If Sweet Baby Ray wants it, then they... You know what? They get the beer and wine only, okay? You know what? They could cater a party out of their other restaurant in Elk Grove and bring it in this town because they connected. I mean, the same company. I'm not happy with hard liquor going to parties around our town for catering. I really not. I think if they have a beer and wine license, that's what they should get, and that's it. For us to monitor it, I think then what's going to happen, if it's in our town, then I think it's going to be up to the company, whoever they cater with, let us know where that party's at. For we could check and make sure there ain't any hard liquor being served at that party. I just don't think it's right. I mean, how do you monitor it? I mean, they need to give us a list on where that party's at, and maybe we need to send a squad car in there and make sure they only got the beer and wine liquor license. That's my own choice. I mean, whatever the council wants to do, that's fine. But the way I feel right now, the way this is written, I would not vote yes for it.
Okay, anything further?
I make the motion that we accept the mayor's $500 and $250 for the license.
I think you made the motion, so does the seconder agree?
Yes.
Okay, anything further? So the motion is approve this ordinance for 3 catering licenses, add a fee of $500 and the renewal of $250. Anything further? Roll call.
Roll call.
Yeah, well, okay. Alderman Coles?
Yes.
Alderman Police?
No.
Alderman Knipe?
Yes.
Alderman Shockey?
Yes.
Alderman Winger?
Yes.
Alderman Wesley?
No.
Alderman Lewitan?
Yes.
Passes.
All right, that passes ordinance 00737.
That's my...
Concludes your report?
End of my report.
Thank you. Public Works, Alderman Winger.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor. I have no report.
Finance and Administration, Alderman Wesley.
No report, Mayor.
Community and Economic Development, Alderman Lewitan.
Thank you, Mayor. I'd like to show that there's that we do have a report. Where is it? I'm sorry. I'm thinking ahead to next week. There's no report.
Thank you. We do not have any other business. We do not need an executive session. There are no items to be referred. There are no items for information only, other than the Boy Scout spaghetti dinner, which is this Saturday at Holy Ghost. May I have a motion to adjourn?
So moved.
Is there a second? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Aye. Motion carries. I think it was all.
I made a motion.